And here means this is to me it is sad. Means it's 60 years means okay, it is the something that after a few years maybe I have to leave him. Okay, so actually this is my interaction with Professor Mandal in the first day. In the first day, incidentally, he was in the interview committee when I came in TIFA to give the interview. Okay, so that's the thing. And then, but the incidental, maybe if he's not here, I might be in TIFA. That's that other issue. But my particular physics career started with him. He taught us this first lesson of the particle physics, how the matter and particle interact. And then my second lesson is this real with this experiment. That time, this Professor Narasimhan and Professor Mandal, they are trying to build, started the building this muon detector in D0. That you have seen the pictures. But like RPC, that was also started with first 20 centimeter, 30 centimeter small prototypes. And I had this with them, means they guided me just to build that. So that's my starting in the high energy physics experiments. Okay, so that's the thing I started. Then I have this last 20 years, I have almost constant touch with him, except in the 3 years gap when I was in postdoctoral work in outside. And when I came back, and the first, within the few days, we have in DA Symposium in Hyderabad, and there, this discussion of the INO came into the picture again, and I saw these people are talking, we will do this neutron experiment, there is many people's around who show the enthusiasms. And then gradually in last 11 years I saw that many people show the enthusiasm, but in the real hardware then there is not many people to do this work. And that time I was gradually more and more surprised that how he take this burden, and when not many people as promised is not going along with him. So this is the one point I just emphasize again and again. Like me, I have to say that like me and many others, we are just taking this very easy path to do this career, to build the career. We have an experiment was done somewhere, just participate there, or somewhere people make these detectors, just take it here and build it and send it back. That is the way we try to build our career. But he is the only person whom I see that he deviating from that. And in that sense, I can only say that he is the person who is trying to revive the high energy physics in India in experimental high energy physics. Otherwise, the way traditionally people are doing here this high energy physics, it will die this Indian high energy physics. And so, and that's it. One more thing I have to say about this. So, not only him, the Swapnadi also, I think I am grateful to her. When we are the student, and since that time to time we had a good dinner in their place, and particularly I am very much of particular, I like this particular DSS, and I enforce her to make the DSS for me, and she always does that. Okay, thanks.
Anybody else? Yeah, okay. Indu.
A lot of things have been said. I just want to say a few things which are my personal interaction with Naba. What I want to discuss, actually three things. One is during our site search for INO, even in the earlier site and even in the present site, we've had a lot of opposition. It's all in the papers, everyone has read about it. But what I really appreciated was two things. In the first site, there were many environmental concerns. A lot of environmental scientists, part of them opposed, part of them supported us. But one thing that Naba was always very clear about, which I really liked, he never had any hesitation in saying, let us find out really what is the environmental difficulty in this site. Let us try to find out how best to actually negotiate around this, whether we can actually keep it to the manageable level. We actually commissioned an extra study for this, and at any time at all. See, there's a small group of us who spoke Tamil, who were interacting directly with the people, local people around there. But we never had any feeling at all that something would not be done because it's expensive or that you know it's not necessary. His concern for the environment, his sensitivity to these issues are something that I really appreciated, because that was really the first time when I interacted so deeply with Naba, not having seen him during his KGF days. So I was very happy. I mean, certain bonding, certain trust that really, you know, he's the right leader, he's doing things right, and that, you know, whatever we felt about it, we could express very clearly, and he would always support us in these decisions that came across for the first time. In fact, little things like we had this meeting with a group of people who were protesting the project. I was discussing it in Tamil. That time Professor Rajshekaran could not be there. Deepak Samuel was there. So he was hearing this entire discussion in Tamil, and we were going over the points. And he had such a sense, such a sensitivity to what was happening, that he actually interrupted, I remember, this conversation in between and said, "Look, I don't know what exactly you're discussing, but I want to very clearly tell you the following." And in English, you know, very slowly, simply, so that they could understand, he said, "We are not going to do something that will adversely affect either the society living here or the environment." And that really, you could see the way the people reacted to the way, the sense of what he was saying, and got convinced by how he was saying it. So that is something about him I really, really appreciate. This fearlessness, concern about the environment. Other is his absolute integrity and straightforwardness. For me, actually, with INO, my interactions with INO, Professor Rajshekaran, Professor Murthy, and Professor Naba Mandal, these are the three, the triumvirate, actually, for me. In very important issues, not just concerned with INO, but in many issues related, because this is a project which has involved, you know, scientists, geologists, engineers, and society, which is a very unusual component in a project like this. And this feature is so important and has come across. I really appreciate that the INO leadership has such worthy people, really, to lead it. Naba and I have not always seen eye to eye. Maybe in future also we will not see eye to eye. I'm not one of the PMC members or some big person in the project. What I really appreciate is that whenever I have brought these concerns to him, he has always patiently written back, clearly explained his stand, whether I agreed with it or not. I really appreciate that, Naba. I must say that, you know, this is something that I'm very proud and to be able to say in public today. That's one reason I came today to say it, that I look forward to, you know, just like all these years that we have had together, I look forward to many more years of you being with us in INO. Maybe more bottles of beer if it helps. But I really want to say that I have really appreciated your contributions to this project. Very difficult times that we have had, and maybe not fully out of the woods yet. But I'd like to wish you and Sapna also, many, many more years with INO and with this.
We don't have that much time. I have known Naba since about maybe 10 to 12 years, ever since I also got associated with the INO project. Although I have been coming to TIFR since about 75, and I have seen him around, and I knew, of course, that he was a very good experimental physicist associated with the premier project at that time of the TIFR, the proton decay experiment. But nevertheless, I was in the area of low energy physics, working at energies about 100,000, 10 to 100,000 times lower than what he was in nuclear physics. Over the years, my interactions with him have grown, and I think it was very pleasant working with him, especially, as was pointed out, for his complete honesty and openness. I mean, that's one of the very nice qualities which I have seen in him. Of course, I have sometimes we have had discussions in which he has expressed his impatience at the pace of movement of things in the INO project, especially those that BRC has been responsible for. But I guess, doing things with neutrinos, which takes time, I think I will request him to bear with us, but I think things will move forward very soon, and more quickly than they have in the past. Okay, I wish him a very fruitful and even more active period in the years to come, and we will need it. All the qualities that will be needed, determination, patience, and so on. And I wish him all the best, and also for his wife, I also know, my wife has also faced similar things. So I wish him all the best in the future. Thank you.